गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। टुडे वी विल टू स्टार्ट आवर लेक्चर ऑन द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द रोड्स। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कसिंग डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द 20-year प्लान एंड सो ऑन। ओके, सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कसिंग द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द रोड्स। ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ द रोड। द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रोड्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू कैटेगरीज डिपेंडिंग ऑन वेदर दे कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर द डिफरेंट सीजन ऑफ द ईयर। द वन इज अ ऑल वेदर रोड एंड सेकंड इज अ फेयर वेदर रोड। ओके, सो व्हाट इज अ ऑल वेदर रोड? सो ऑल वेदर रोड इज दैट द काइंड ऑफ द रोड व्हिच आर यूज्ड बाय द व्हीकल और बाय द यूजर्स throughout the year. Okay, so there are no particular seasons are available. Like some kind of the roads are typically not used in the monsoon season due to the potholes and muds and so. But all other road other roads are those which are negotiable during all the weather except at the major river crossing where interruption of traffic is permissible. Upon a certain extent, the road payment should be negotiated during all weather. Roads which are called the fair weather road, on this road, the traffic may be interrupted during monsoon season at causeway where the streams may overflow over the road. Okay, so there are the two different kinds of types of the roads are available, all weather road as well as a fair weather road. So all weather road is that which are used all time, which kind of the road used in all season. Okay, so it is called the all weather road, and the fair weather road are this road the traffic may be interrupted or prevented during the monsoon season at a causeway where the stream may overflow across the road. Okay. Next is a based on the type of the carriageway. Based on the type of the carriageway of the road pavement, the road are classified as a paved road, unpaved road. Okay, so what is the paved road and what is the unpaved road? So the paved road, if they are provided with the hard pavement course, which should be at least a water-bound magnet layer. So what is called the paved road? If they are provided with a hard pavement course, which should be at least a water-bound magnet. So in the previous lecture, we have studied what is a magnet road and WBM road, water-bound magnet road. So this kind of road have a particular specifications. They have different types of the layers. Like the first, the sub-base layer. On the top of the sub-base layer, there is a base layer, and on the top layer, it is a surface layer. So water-bound magnet layers. So if they are provided with the hard pavement course, which should be at least a water-bound magnet layer. Unpaved roads. Unpaved road, if they are not provided with the hard pavement course of at least a WBM layer, thus earth road and gravel roads may be called the unpaved road. So based on the type of the carriageway or the road pavement, there are two classifications. One is a paved road and second is a unpaved road. Okay, next is a based on the type of the So, based on the type of the pavement surface provided, surface road and unsurface road. So, surface road which are provided with the bituminous or cement concrete surface, it's called the surface road. And unsurface roads which are not provided with the bituminous or the cement concrete surfaces, the roads provided with the bituminous surfaces are also called the black top roads. Okay, so there are the different types of the roads are available. Based on the classification, like the paved road, unpaved road, paved road, unpaved road, all weather road, fair weather road, and surface road and unsurface road. Okay, so just take a look about the different classifications. like the all weather road as well as the fair weather road and paved road and unpaved road and the surface road and unsurface road. Okay, so the next one is a method of classification of the road. So, in the above classification, there are the different types of the roads which are used, but the next one is a method of the classification of road. So, the roads are generally classified on the following basis: the traffic volume, the load transport or tonnage, and the load and location or function. The classification based on the traffic volume or tonnage have been attributively fixed by the different agents, by the different agencies, and there may not be common agreement regarding the limits for each of the classification groups. Based on the traffic volume, the roads are classified as heavy, medium, and light traffic roads. These terms are relative, and so the limits under each class should be clearly defined and expressed as a vehicle per day. So, methods of the classification rule, the various factors or the various followings which are taken into account, like the traffic volume, road transport, and the location and the function. Okay, so the traffic volume is that on a day, on a single day, what are the maximum vehicle count are passing at a particular stretch? It's called the traffic volume or the number of the vehicles passing at a certain stretch or in a certain time. The total count of the vehicle is called the traffic volume, load transport, and tonnage. So there are the different classification of the tonnages, like the heavy tonnage or a medium tonnage or light tonnage. So when any urban area or any minor district road are constructed, so they are taking into account that not more than this amount of the weighted vehicle are passed at that certain particular location. So the second one is a load transported and tonnage, and the last is a location and the function. The classification based on the location and functions should therefore be more acceptable classification for the country as they may define clearly. The Nagpur road plan classifies the roads in India like the national highway, state highway, major district road, minor other district road, and village road. Okay, so there are the five classification: national highway, state highway, major district road, other district road, as well as a village road. Okay, so the classification of roads by the Nagpur road plan. So there are the different types of the classification, like what is called the national highway, what is called the state highway, what is a major district road, what is other district road, and what is a village road. Okay, so in the national highway are the main highway running through the length of breadth of India, breadth of India, connecting major ports, foreign highways, capital of large states, and large industries and the tourist centers, including roads required for the strategic movement of the for the defense of India. It was agreed that the first step national train should be constructed by the center, and that later that should be converted into a road to suit the traffic condition. It was specified that a national highway should be the frame on which the entire road communication should be based, and that these highways may not necessarily be the same specification. Okay, all the national highway are assigned with the respective manners. So there are a kind of a notations are given, like NH1, NH2, NH3, NH44, NH8, and so on. The national highway which passes in the vicinity of Ahmedabad has name as NH8, Golden Quadrilateral National Highway Scheme. So what is the Golden Quadrilateral National Highway Scheme? So the main aim to develop this kind of the highway is to connecting the four major cities of India, named Delhi, Mumbai, मुंबई, कोलकाता एंड चेन्नई, एंड कनेक्टिंग दिस फोर मेजर मेट्रो सिटीज ऑफ इंडिया, अ पर्टिकुलर हाईवे स्कीम इज लॉन्च्ड, सो इट इज नेम्ड एज नेशनल हाईवे 8. द हाईवे कनेक्टिंग दिल्ली अंबाला अमृतसर इज डिनोटेड एज NH1, वेर एज अ यूनिफिकेशन ऑफ दिस हाईवे बियॉन्ड जलंधर टू श्रीनगर एंड उरी इज डिनोटेड NH18. द हाईवे कनेक्टिंग मदुराई एंड रामेश्वरम इज NH49 एंड बॉम्बे आगरा रोड इज NH3. अ मैप शोइंग अ नेशनल हाईवे इन हाईवे. ओके, सो नेशनल हाईवे इज दैट विच कनेक्टिंग द मेजर पार्ट्स एंड मेजर लोकेशन ऑफ इंडिया एंड सम काइंड ऑफ फॉर स्ट्रेटेजिक मैनर और आर मूविंग द मिलिट्री ट्रूप्स फ्रॉम वन लोकेशन टू अनदर लोकेशन. दिस काइंड ऑफ द नेशनल हाईवे इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड. द नेक्स्ट इज द स्टेट हाईवे. स्टेट आर द स्टेट हाईवेज आर आर्टेरियल रोड ऑफ अ स्टेट कनेक्टिंग अप विद द नेशनल हाईवे ऑफ एडजेसेंट स्टेट डिस्ट्रिक्ट हेड क्वार्टर्स एंड इम्पोर्टेंट सिटीज विद इन द स्टेट एंड सर्विंग द मेन आर्टरीज फॉर द ट्राफिक टू एंड फ्रॉम डिस्ट्रिक्ट रोड. सो द स्टेट हाईवे इज सेकेंडरी पोर्शन ऑफ द नेशनल हाईवे. सो द स्टेट ओनली इज स्टेटेड दैट इम्पोर्टेंट रोड ऑफ एनी स्टेट or important roads which are connecting two different cities of a particular state, it's called the state highway. These highways are considered as a main arteries of the commerce by the roads with the state or a similar geographical unit. In some places, they may even carry heavier traffic than some of the national highways, but this will not alter their designation or function. The NH and SH have the same design speed and the geometric design specifications. Next is a major district road. MDR are important road with the district serving area of production and markets connecting those with each other or with the main highway of a district. The MDR has a lower speed and geometric design specification than NH and SH. Okay, so major district road or the work of the major district road is to provide a feeder services from the feeder services to the state highway as well as the national highway. Any important road which are created or developed inside the city area or in the vicinity of the city, so it is called the major district road. So the major district road is that connecting the two particular areas of a city or connecting the two small cities with the help of that road network. Okay, the next is the other district road. Are roads serving rural areas of production and providing them with the outlet to the market centers, taluka headquarters, block development headquarters, and other main roads. These are the lower design specification than the MDR. And the last one is the village road. Are roads connecting village or groups of villages with each other to the nearest road of a higher category. Okay, so based on the Nagpur road plan, there are the different classification like the national highways, state highways, major district road, other district road, or as in other terms called the minor district road and the village road. Okay. So in the modified classification of a road system by the third road development plan. Okay. So the Nagpur road plan gave us introduction of the different types of the road or give a introductory information about that kind of the particular road system. But in the third road development plan in the 1981 to 2001, there are the classification modification are occur in the different classification. So there are three main classification are amend. Primary system, secondary system, and a territorial system or ruler road. Okay, so the primary system consisted expressway as well as the national highways. Okay, But what is expressway? So it is a kind of a other expressway are the separate class of a highway with a superior facility and a design standard and are meant to meant as through routes having a very high volume of the traffic. So the expressway between Ahmedabad and Baroda it's called the expressway, which are also a part of a national highway. But at that particular point, a superior specification and design consideration are going to affect and why it is necessary to develop any expressway or expressway in a national highway. Because if there are a high number of the traffic volumes are available, which cannot justifiable with the help of the national highway, so the kind of this facility or kind of the expressway are developed for providing the fast and efficient movement from the one location to another location. But on the other hand, expressway is a kind of a shorter in duration rather than the national highways. The expressway are to be provided with the divided carriageways, controlled access, grade separation at crossroad and fencing. This highway should permit only fast-moving vehicles. Express may be owned by the central government or the state government, depending on whether the route is a national highway or a state highway. The secondary system consists of the two categories of the road, state highway and the major district road, and the territorial system are rural roads, and that consists of the two categories of the road, the other district road as well as the village road. So nothing new or nothing any thing new are implemented, but just providing but just define kind of the particular classification of the road in the three manner, primary system, secondary system and the territorial system or the territory system. Okay, so the primary system consists of the expressway and the national highway. So in the third 20-year plan, an expressway or a class of the expressway are included in the rule book of the highway planning. So expressway is the newer concept rather than the national highway and the state highways. So expressway are amend in the rule book of the highway planning. So in the third 20-year plan, this kind of the classification or the modification of classification are going to taking place. Okay, in the next lecture we will discussing the classification of the urban roads. So in the previous in today's lecture we were discussing we were discussed a different types of the classification of the highways or different types of the road. But in the next lecture we will focus on the only classification of the urban road or roads which are available in the urban area for the day-to-day movement of the passenger as well as the goods. So in the next lecture we will discuss the classification of the urban roads, classification of the urban road. So see you in the next lecture. Thank you.